With that said, I'd like to open up the meeting to citizen comments, and I'll start on the right side of the room. Anybody from the first row would like to come speak? Anybody from the second row? Anybody all from the right side of the room would like to come speak? Yes.
My name is Laura Schreiber. I live at 6,000 Village Way, apartment 404, Creekside Village. I'm here as a secretary of the Board of Trustees of the library, and I'm also president of the Friends of the Library. I'm here because I'm wondering what's happening. We were contacted in August. We have been about having a new library on Kingsman Avenue, or Kingsman Road, and we have been trying to follow all of the wishes of you and George. And we have gotten signatures from people in that area, more than half. For those people who've never answered their door, we went there twice around the whole area, got signatures, and then we sent a letter. And some people have responded to that letter in a positive way, but we have not been able to have a meeting lately with you or George or anything about this, and they said they're putting it off until January. I guess that's the earliest. And I just wondered what was going on, because when George first came to us in August, I think it was, he was like, this is a plan and we'd like to get your input, and we were very positive for that plan. And now it is December.
Well, I emailed Betsy earlier this week, and I told her I won't be available until after the holidays.
I understand that, and we don't know why we can't have a meeting before then, before January. Why wouldn't it be allowed, you know?
Well, anybody can meet, but I personally wouldn't be available until after the holidays, and I'd be more than happy to meet with the library. My understanding about the petition is this. There's roughly 17,000 to 18,000 residents that live in Upper Chichester. We got a petition with 150 signatures. And some of the signatures on the petition were duplicate names, and some of the signatures on the petition were individuals that didn't live in the council also. So I wanted to meet with the library to see them to maybe come up with a better way of how to get the community support larger.
This was not asked for the community support, it was asked for a specific neighborhood.
Ma'am, I don't know what information that was
what we were told.
We were the
George, isn't that
the,
true?
Ma'am, the intent was to first to see if that particular community was interested in it, and if the whole township was interested in it also. So the signatures that were received from the neighborhood, some of them were duplicate names.
I know, and we've straightened that out,
right,
and we have it all cleaned up.
Right. So I like to get the community behind it more, and I like to sit down with the library to see how we can work together in order to do that.
We would love to sit down.
It's just,
Laura, have you sent the updated petitions to the township? Has Betsy sent the updated?
I don't know. But all I know is that, you know, we were only asked for that specific area.
So that's initially, yes. So initially we want
bodies. So now you're saying you want the whole community.
So let me finish. Initially, we want the immediate community that's going to be impacted by the library going in that spot, right? So we want to know the people that are living there, mm-hmm, if they want that to be there as a part of the home, right? So that's the first step. The second part of that is buying from the community, okay? So when we received the petitions, there were a combination of petitions. The first one, the one that has been sitting at the township, excuse me, at the library. And then Betsy put that in, as well as the one with.
Where we went around.
Exactly, where it was multiple duplicate names. So that's been cleaned up, as you see. Okay, and since then, we've been trying to get a meeting. Dawn hasn't been available, I wasn't available, Mike wasn't available. So we've been trying to schedule a meeting so that we can review next steps. So if you want to, I'm in town, and I think George will be in town, but Mike won't be here. So we can schedule something before the first of the year as a, you know, check-in, but nothing formal is going to happen until January.
I understand. But I'd like to, I mean, as long as we can clear up what we need to do, because we're very willing to do lots of stuff.
Right.
I just think we need more buy-in from the community. If I have roughly 18,000 residents, right, and I got 150 signatures, that doesn't speak volumes.
Well, that wasn't what we were asked to do.
Well, I think that wasn't communicated clearly to you, so.
Well, I just like, as long as we can move forward. I mean, to get to have a mock-up of what a library would look like in the park, that's a very exciting thing for us. And to have, say, this would be an area. To have it just keep getting, you know, changing the rules or what we're doing, it just doesn't seem fair.
Just real quick, this is a very large project. And, you know, as you probably have seen being in the township for some time, in government, large projects take a significant amount of time. So, like, between August and now is like a microcosm in time in government. There's so many different steps and things that have to happen and processes. So meeting in January, I think, is a very reasonable time for you to start and lay down what's the next steps. At this point, we need to flush out those signatures that came in, because the signatures came in to me to vet as the township manager, and the first thing I had to do was go through, and I saw that the library gave me duplicate signatures. So my report back to the board was, I received signatures, but there's duplicates here. So we're going to need to vet this further with the library. And I think the thing we're trying to get to is where is the list of the people that don't do the duplicates?
All right, I hope you can set up a time to meet and get it done because it's very frustrating. We will set up a time.
But we can't move forward either. I just want to make it clear that we didn't change any parameters. The parameters which I stated and which Ms. Whitaker stated also, that was communicated clearly. So I just want to get that out on the record.
Well, obviously it didn't come through.
Can I ask a question?
Mm-hmm.
What is the expectation of the library on? I think we did, I mean, trust me, I'm the first to tell you, government's either reverse or stop. And it frustrates me sitting up here with a lot of things, right? It's just snappy fingers done. It doesn't happen. But I understand, I just don't understand. I think this board took this step by having a draft of a building, not a guaranteed building of what is going to be over. To give people the concept of this is what we would like to see
right. For
the future. Your future may not be until 2 to 3 years from now, but it sounds to me we want it tomorrow.
No, I don't expect it to be tomorrow because we have to raise all the money for the library. It doesn't come from the township. The money for building the library is we have to get. We understand that. That is not going to be money that's coming from taxes. But we can't even apply or think about it until we have a definite plan, a definite space, a definite architectural plan. We can't move ahead. And that's why we think it'll be years before this is built. I hope I live that long. But it's It is in the future. We understand that. But the library has grown out of its space. That horrible referendum that we had that went down. Since that time, I think we had maybe 1,200 members of the library. We now have over 4,000. That's a lot for a little library like that in this community. And it has so many programs and does such good work for no matter what age in the community, children, adults, seniors, people looking for jobs, and we're there to help them. I'm sorry I'm taking up so much time, but it's something that is very important to me. Okay, thank you very much. And I hope you can set up a meeting before you go on vacation, that you'll have it set up just in time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anybody from the left side of the room like to come speak?